Okay, good morning guys. Today I'm fishing the annual River Wye championships. It's been a match that I've never actually won, but I've had 2 seconds. I've come second in it twice, with some big weights as well, 84 pound and 82 pound. 1 year I only got beat by 2 pound for the championships, but you know, this match is very lucky. Some guys have gone on and won it, you know, 4 or 5 times, you know, like John Harvey and that, you know. And the draw was made on the Friday, if anyone's seen that on Facebook, it was live. And I drew A-section, which is in Brainton. Now, if anyone who follows me will know that I was drawn up here in the charity match. And I was just... on the last peg running into a very shallow water, and I had a load of puppies and had a hold of my net and I lost a lot of fish that day. And the two pegs above, they had big dog chub. Now, they've done the draw for the numbers this morning, and I drew peg 8, which is the peg that everyone wanted, I think, and that was... peg 8, which is like 2 above the blockhouse, where John Holloway had 90-odd pound. Now, before we get too excited, the river's coming up. What a bummer. If on a normal river, I would have fancied to win the match. You know, that's how confident I would have been. However, the river's coming up. It's already come up half a metre, and they reckon it's going to come up another metre. At the moment it's fishable, but we don't start for another hour and a half yet, so I got here early. And I'll show you now, it's starting to boil and starting to run through pretty fast. So, but anyway, the fish do live here, and it's whether they're going to be in a feeding mood. Got a feeling be more barbel today than chub, but you never know, you never know. Right, let's have a look at the swim so I can show you now. Okay, there you are. It's a bit of a steep drop. Bit of a slack coming on the inside. But see where those leaves are going? That's where you would normally fish it. And it's absolutely started to bomb through. So the only hope I got is the fish have moved, have come in, you know, to the slack of water. And hopefully I might get a couple. But as I say, it's starting to colour up. It's starting to get murky. It's not going to be a normal match, you know, when a float fishing match, I wouldn't have thought. It might be a more of a feeder job. Okay, well, as I say, it's just my luck for this to happen on, you know, drawing the right peg, but on the wrong day. Anyway, I'll tackle up now and I'll speak to you just before the start. Okay, the match is just starting. I just put a couple of balls in the ground bait. The only problem is it's coming up quickly, so I might have to move sort of the peg, you know. It's come up at least 12 inches already, so anyway. I'm going to start on the float and then possibly end up on the feeder. Bunch of maggots. it's just going through too fast, I think. I'll keep putting some ground bait in, try and get some feed in there before the river really comes up. And here comes the rain. Good start, isn't it? Could be one of their matches, I think. Aren't trees coming down in the middle of the river? now we got the leaves contend with now. I'm making like flat pancakes so we don't roll away. I think those bleak pegs are going to be a favourite today. Looking at this now. Here comes the rain. Okay, well, I just lost one of the biggest bloody barbels I've ever had on in my life then. I've gone on the feeder and basically it just took me downstream and just kept going. Oh, I don't know. Could be a sign there, it's a few year mines. That's good. Horrible day now, it's bloody rain coming down and the they say it will clear up in a minute. Let's hope so. Yeah, three maggots on a bloody size 14. Forged, and it bent the hook. Would you believe? I'm only about three rod lengths out. Any further, and it's, you know, it's going throughout the train, so. Oh, just snagged up and lost the hook. No. Yeah, that was a massive barbel. I mean, I've had 10-pound barbel before. I wouldn't have known any better. I'd have said that was bigger. But of course, you know, with the pressure of the water, and I, you know, and he sort of made a, you know, a head of steam, like, you know, like a train, and he just kept going. Anyway. If there's one, there's got to be some more, surely. Mind you, this river's coming up. I might have to move up the bank a little bit after. So, not pretty viewing today, unfortunately. this type of fishing, you know, it's you know, sort of a waiting game, really. When it colours up, I'm going to go on the meat then, but at the moment I'm just fishing a maggot and put some hempfen casters in. And my barbel ground bait. Got like a garlicky, fishy smell. And sort of holding the rod a little bit, so the thing is, it's either big fish or nothing up here. There's no day so bleak to go for. Yeah, just can't, you know, I can't believe that barbel, and it sort of kicked. And then it ran, and I thought, well, I'd backwind on it, but it just kept backwinding and winding, and, you know, it went right past down that bush down there. And I thought, I'd put a bit of pressure on it, try and bring it back up, and the hook straightened out. The one that got away. So it's a bit of a waiting game, unfortunately. Sorry about that. Lads, it's just, you know. Oh. Yeah, I got one. Small one. Only a puppy. Yeah, there's one there, gotta be more there. Try and angle the camera so you can see a bit better, I think, because at the moment all you see is me. Probably about 8 foot deep there, 7-8 foot. Of course, it's coming up a bit. It's come up about 6 inches now in the last 20 minutes. There's still, you know, it's not a colour in it, it's not a chocolate colour yet. Right, now this is a little dodge we do when the leaves go down the line. What we do, we put a BB just above the on the hook length, and that'll stop the leaves from, you know, travelling down to on the hook. So you see that? So you got a little BB there. Right. So that should stop the leaves from covering the bait. Plus, of course, that extra shot, you know, then the bait's on the bottom rather than sort of flopping around up in the water. Of course, the other conclusion that Babbler lost could have been a foul up one, you know, so, you know, I would have made the weight of it twice as big. Well, the rain stopped, but I'm under a tree and I'm still getting spots off the tree, so keep the umbrella for a little bit longer. Oh, John, I was really looking forward to fishing a float today. It's not my favourite method, the feeder, but you know, you have to do it sometimes. Yeah, it's worth striking at every little movement, you know, you never know. You haven't always got to wait for the tip to bang round, you know. Well, I don't. No more bites at the moment, so I'm sure you just want to sit there watching my tip. So I'll just turn it off at the moment and come back on when I get some action. Okay. Well, not much has happened. The river's coming up, and I'm getting wet. I haven't had any more bites, so could be an early bath here today, the way it's going. They're catching down on the Belmont though. I just spoke to Russell. He said they're, you know, catching a few, you know, because the fish is down there when the water comes up. Up here, it just goes too fast, and the fish just don't feed. Just too fast for them. Just about holding bottom with 45 grams at the moment. Yeah, mate. Probably won't draw this again though. I'll have to move up the bank in a minute because I'm basically touching my feet now, the water. Oh, at least I haven't had a blank. I've had one fish anyway. Okay. Yeah, well, still nothing. It is a bit of a slack start in the form on the inside, but whether there's any fish in it, I don't know. As soon as it stops raining, I'm going to move up the bank a little bit anyway. It's getting boily like a washing machine here. No. And have a look how the other lads are doing in this section, I think. Well, I compromised. I started catching bleak on the feeder. And I thought, bloody hell. So I could have perhaps changed my bait, you know, and, you know, gone for bigger fish. But, you know, I was looking for those roach and dace that started. And then all of a sudden I got the bleak. And then the trouble is I haven't got a whip set up. So what I've done, I put a smaller hook on my little chubber. And I'm sort of... improvising, catching them down the stream, like, you know, yeah. I even met me turn, like, so, I don't know why I'm doing it, probably just for the section, like, you know, because the two guys below me, one's packed up and the other one's not bothering, you know, so, you know, I'm just, yeah, that's up to doing it, you know, depends if they, you know, the other lads up there have caught. You know, if they caught any barbel or chub, like, you know, but it's a funny old game fishing, isn't it? You know, you never know what's going to come next, like. You know, I should have had a proper whip set up, but I didn't think I'd be catching bleak, you know. Yeah, my. As I say, it's something to do. That's the magic about this wine, because, you know, if you can't catch, you know, if the water comes up and you can't catch normal fish, you've always got bleak to go for. I mean, they just turned up, these bleak. I wasn't getting them earlier. Well, I did see the odd telltale sign. I seen a couple blimping early on. But, you know, who knows? If I'd gone for more match, would they have been there? I don't think so. Yeah, no, I'm just playing catch-up, really, if anyone else is catching the bleak. Well, I was going to move. I haven't moved. I'm sort of up to my ankles in water now. I left all my whips in the bloody car. Anyway. As I say, but, you know, I wanted something that was really expected today. As long as you have a day's fishing, I suppose, at the end of the day, isn't it? Yeah, they're, you know, they're not bad size. A lot of them are small, but, you know, I've not had any of those big kippers yet. So I can get them out in the flow as well, so, you know. Just turn the cameras so you can see what I'm doing. This boilie, they're sort of everywhere, you know. Can't seem to get them in one spot. Disappeared. Catching chub on a loafer. The catching bleak on a loafer. Who would have thought it? Come and go. Slightly bigger ones. Obviously, it's not the ideal, scenario, this. But, when you're mat fishing sometimes, you've got to improvise, haven't you? And that's what I'm doing here. And I could have set up a smaller stick or something, but, I think time sometimes is an essence. By the time I set the stick up, I could have had a pound of bleak in the net. Yes, I'll be doing this. Somebody's got a babble or a trip or something. A couple of bloody... I mean, the trip I got is only a small one. I still got it, but that babble might have lost. But the more I think about it, the more I think he was foul up, because I couldn't turn him at all. He just kept going and going, Sort of what the time is doing. I think it was only about an hour to go. I'd gone on these really too late, but it's the thing, it's just for the section really. See if I can get, get a section right. I can't believe that. People on a boat in this river. We're almost... Those stand up things.
Like that PA-28's got like a hand brake, so you brake, whereas the C-152's got like pedal brakes, where the pedals are, just differences in the cockpit and power settings and cruise speed and all that, all the different.
This is almost as fast as a whip, almost, isn't it? Probably not quite as quick, but, cover more area with it. I'm bumping a few mines, so, you know, maybe that bulk is causing a problem in that sometimes. I bet there'll be some weights down the bottom on these bleaks today. So greedy, bleak, and eh? I think they're the only fish I've ever seen still feeding in the keep net. I remember having a net of them once, and I was throwing some maggots in the keep net, and I seen the bleak actually eating them. Eating the maggots while they've been caught, like. I suppose the advantage of a running line is that, you know, especially in conditions like this, when the, you know, they're all sort of, you know, moving around with the flow, you know, with the currents, you're not always going to get them in the same spot like you would, you know, with a whip, and you're a bit limited to what's in front of you. But with this, at least you can trot down and catch a few, you know. Yeah, I think that is a problem. I am bumping a few with this, you know, it's a five swan open I got here. So, but in one breath, it's actually slowing the, you know, the float up, the bait in the water. You know, so, you know. But a lighter whip or float would just, you know, it just, you know, it catch the flow and it might go too fast. So this is actually, you know, holding the bait up. Hey? Hold on then. See, I'm catching right down there. No, you wouldn't catch them down there on a whip, you know. Well, this type of rig is might be worth sort of you know setting up. You know, if the bleak sort of move downstream, then you know, obviously if it's fast flowing like this, you know, sort of holding, you know, it's holding the bait up. If you could see this, its currents, it's really, you know. There's a kipper the size of that one. They're worth going for, these are. Ooh, come up. Yeah, she's boiling as hell and because of that, I think the bleak sort of move out with a boil. It disappeared. There somewhere. They're always there. And that water's actually coming back on itself under the earth, but I don't know whether they're catching that close in. Funny, I just found him back out in the, you know, out in the fast throw. Makes you wonder how they live there sometimes. Unbelievable, you wouldn't think they'd live out in the fast water sometimes like that. Oh! disappeared for a minute. Right down the swim then. Now you wouldn't have got that on a whipsy. Funny, you get spasms really. You get one or two other trot and then you're searching for a minute. Like the bigger ones out in the flow as well. I know they're not everyone's cup of tea, but you know, in matches sometimes you gotta go for them. Don't seem to be going for a suck maggot that much. I seem to wait longer for bites. in the bloody rain again. I'm fishing a double at the moment. See if I can catch a few more on the you know, without free baiting. Yeah, definitely smaller, closer in, bigger out. Different in size then. Definitely bigger outside there. Check the time, I think. Yeah, 15 minutes to go. It's a shame I've only been on these bleak for about, well, I'm just looking now. 35 minutes. If I could have done this for 5 hours, I would have probably had a wait. I said I could be wasting my time here doing it, but you know, it's keeping me busy anyway. Oops. See, it was only a last resort to try and see to get a section really. The only reason I went for them is because on the feeder I was getting them on the feeder. They were taking doubles and triple maggots. Rain's coming again. Okay, it's been a funny old match. As I say, I lost that barbel to give him with. And then a little chub, then those roach on the days, and then the bleak at the end. And I'm glad I went for the bleak, because I ended up winning the section with £8.4. I think it was £5 something was second, so in the mini section. So here, yeah, it was worth 50 quid, I think, to me. So, yeah. Not as good as winning a match, of course, but, you know, as I say, sometimes you've got to change tactics. Sometimes you've got to improvise, which I did, and it paid off. So there. Anyway, next time I'll be up here now will be the 3-day festival. Let's hope the water drops and we get some decent fishing. Okay then, thanks for watching. I'll show you a picture of my bag of fish. Little chub, cut roach and some bleak. Okay, thanks. See you next time.